Oh, yeah. Oh, hideous. It's, I think that's hideous.
It's a Star Trek.
Star Trek.
Phaser.
That's funny. Yorna. Hey everyone, James Reeves with TFB TV. Thanks for tuning in. We are live at the Beretta Museum. I'm here with my friend Yarno, I call him, and I say this all the time, I think it's funny, the gun librarian. Yarno, he oversees the museum, he's the historian here at Beretta. We're looking at some significant firearms from Beretta's history, and there are some little known firearms from Beretta, including a series of revolvers, correct Yarno?
Yeah, when the company had a plant in São Paulo, Brazil in 1960s and 1970s, they started a project to design a revolver based on a, let's say, innovative mechanic, and they will develop a couple of models. So here we have one of these model called very simple model number one. But they had also other names to promote them commercially in other countries, so they took the name of according to the market. So the Brazilian has a name, the Italian has another name. They were also marketed in Italy at the end of the 1970s, but because the Italian market is not really very welcoming the revolver, but mostly they prefer the semi-automatic pistols, so it was not successful, and in fact they soon left the production. But we have one of these revolver, and in the drawer we have also our samples that were manufactured by Beretta Brazil. So let's say that they were designed in Italy, and then the production was directly made on place in Brazil, because we have to remember that the Brazilian army in 1976 was one of the first to be provided by the 92.
The Model 1, 357, 38, is that?
Yeah, there were different caliber. 38 was the most common one. Let's say that this revolver has been developed and designed according to Smith & Wesson design system. And they wanted to keep something that it was already existing on the market, improving some parts also for the design, giving them the characteristic of Beretta, and also acting on some parts of the safety in order to enhance and improve the safety of the revolver, because you know that the revolver is must be carefully handled, because it's always ready to fire a gun. So in this case they improved the part of the safety. They released it on the market in Italy and in Brazil, and as far as I know, in the US it was never marketed, but it was very popular in South America, as I told you previously.
I certainly have never seen one in the United States.
And here you have also different sizes, as you can see. So that one was the largest one, the biggest size. Then we have also these pocket revolvers.
Are these like 32 caliber?
32, yes. 32, this is the one most used. I will show you also later some brochures about them that we kept in our records, because it was very rare to find it, and very few people know about this this kind of product that Beretta was made in the past, that is really uncommon. And as far as I know, I never seen in our collection. So these are the only ones that it happened to me that I saw them also for the upper guns.
These clearly wouldn't be called the Model 1 as well, would they?
Were Model 1, Model 2.
Model 3, Model 4.
Now, in fact, you see also from the label, you don't have a special. These are all prototypes that were developed in 1940s. But as I told you, the real production was made in 1960s and 1970s for that revolver.
And if there is a Beretta revolver, it was made in Brazil.
Yeah.
All Beretta revolvers designed in Italy, and they were made in South America.
Yeah, when we had the manufacturing plant, obviously not only the revolvers, but also they were produced the 92, some 92 FS. So they kept the plant until 1980s. and now it's not belonging to Beretta anymore, but we still have a good relationship with the Brazilian commitments because we are still keeping on providing them our guns for the commercial and military market as well. So, but that was the starting point at the time.
What about that additional cylinder? Do you know what that is? See the cylinder right here above the metal
one? Because it was interchangeable.
Sure. Do you know what caliber?
Yeah, there was shifting from one caliber to another. So now I don't see which caliber exactly it is, that one. But you can easily interchange the cylinder or replace it for our different kind of operation, for cleaning, for replacing for wearing out, for etc. So it was something proven.
How long did Beretta make revolvers, or at least try to make revolvers, before you said no more?
No, I think that they just lasted 10 years, because then, I told you, being not so successfully for the Italian market, but not because it was not working well, but just because for the preference given to the semi-automatic products, and also because of the capacity. They prefer the pistols. So we have to remember that at the time we had a double stack magazine pistol. Mm-hmm. So it was also on the shooting range more amusing than a revolver. So these are the two, let's say, reason why they left the project, and also because they were concentrated at the time for the US standard, so the M9. So keeping focused on the revolver when you have to develop the M9 for
right.
The standard of the U.S., probably the company adopted the best policy, more convenient for them to concentrate on the semi-automatic market than on the revolver, so they left completely the revolver market. Even if today, you have to remember that a part of Beretta Holding Group, there is a Uberti company that most of the people used familiar with guns know, because Uberti is still producing some revolver branded Beretta, like Laramie revolver or the Gold Rush carbine or the Stampede one in different caliber, and they are branded Beretta, so produced by Uberti here in Gardone Valtrompia. So the company is based just 1 kilometer far away from our museum where we are in, and they are marketing this gun, especially on the US market, but also worldwide, and they are branding the revolver for us. So today you can find the Beretta revolver in the Truth, not made by Beretta, but branded by Beretta from
but those are single
sister
action,
company.
Right?
It's a single action.
See, I think that this, maybe if it had made it to the United States, would have seen some commercial success. Of course, pistols are very popular in the United States, auto loaders are, but revolvers are popular in the U.S.
Yeah,
as well.
This is another kind of, another way of approaching the market for the guns, because for Beretta, I think that to leave the revolver market to Uberti makes sense, because Uberti is already in. Okay, Uberti is not making the new revolvers or new project on this kind of guns. They're just replicating the old U.S. Far West guns from the end of 1800 on. So they're the replica from the most popular, let's say, Far West guns, and they are a little bit modernized today, okay, updated, let's say so, put in the Uberti brand or the Beretta brand. And by the way, in fact, many revolvers made by Uberti were also employed and used in the cinematography, in the movies, from Sergio Leone, the Italian Spaghetti Western with Clint Eastwood actor, and so on.
So this, in a way, the Model 1 was like the unloved Brazilian stepchild of Beretta, unfortunately. I mean, you had other things going on. There were a lot of other projects.
I think that also it's a kind of how people are thinking and are considering Beretta. Beretta is popular for the semi-auto, the over and under, the semi-automatic pistols. So this is the concept when one is in Beretta, the products that is are thinking is this one. Bolt action rifles, revolvers, heavy machine guns, Yes, they were made by Beretta in the past, but they are not so bound to the name of Beretta and to the popularity of the brand of Beretta worldwide, because they are not intended products born under the culture of Beretta. The culture of Beretta is represented by this kind of product that you see here. In fact, you see just one revolver and then semi-automatic pistol. There is a reason.
So how many of these do you think were made, if you know?
A few thousand pieces. I know for sure that just for Italy 200 or 300 were marketed and sold.
Wow.
So you can just see the difference between the American market and our market for the revolvers. I think a couple of thousands, because then they were left and not carry on the business of revolver anymore, and also because we left the plant in order to concentrate on the plant of Maryland that it was established at the end of the 1970s, and so for us, for Beretta, it was much better to focus on the US market and on the base in Maryland than the one in South America, because then the contract with the South American people were finished, were over, so we carry on with our activities in the North America.
While it wasn't commercially successful, I think it's safe for me to assume that if you do have a Model 1 in good condition, it's probably worth a substantial amount of money.
It is not said that in the future, if there will be the requirements and opportunities from the market, Beretta will be more than welcome to re-enter into this market, I think. I think that today the revolver, apart the collectors and some police, I don't think that is a gun that has a huge request from the competition world or from the defense world. There are many passionate also in Europe, not only in America, but the number of this market, I think they are still limited compared to the number of the semi-automatic products.
Well, you guys heard it here first. The Beretta revolver is coming back straight from Jarno, he told us. Jarno, thanks a ton.
Thanks so much. Thanks to you.
Guys, stay tuned. We're going to be bringing you more from the Beretta Museum. Jarno didn't know he just committed to 1 million people that you guys are bringing revolvers back. I'm kidding.
No, maybe.